Sunny isn't feeling sunny. The early morning sun had risen above the unusually bustling town of Maritime Bay. Earth ponies weren't just in the town as they had been for so many moons, but unicorns and pegasi were socializing in the streets and children playing in them. Sheriff Hitch was chasing down a litterer as his bird chicks and crab followed him at only half the speed. Among all the positivity and friendship in the air, Izzy Moonbow was happily trotting through the streets.
I can't wait to get together with every pony!
Izzy giggled as she hopped a couple of times.
We're gonna make friendship bracelets and have a picnic and watch the plants, so many more amazing things.
But before she could get Sunny for their day, she first had an exciting errand to make. The unicorn smiled brightly. She'd found something a few days ago and was deterred by Sunny to likely be an ancient artifact. The unicorn made her way into the Museum of Maritime Bay and went into the back rooms where they examined new donations. But Izzy didn't fully understand the process. She'd rather create things out of everything. She entered the large room where three different tables were lining it. Two unicorns were looking at what Izzy had found that was on display on a stand in the middle of the first table.
So it's legitimate?
The unicorn asked the unicorn next to him.
Yes, we can confirm that this is a weapon used thousands of years ago.
The second unicorn explained, looking out on a table a mostly restored albeit a little weathered machete with tons of intrigue. The first unicorn looked in Izzy's direction.
Hey, what are you doing here?
He asked.
She's the one that found it,
said the second unicorn.
Oh, right,
replied the second, and he smiled.
Thanks so much for the wonderful find.
Booyah!
Izzy pumped a hoof into the air. Without asking permission, Izzy leaned closer to the machete, looking at it with wonder in her eyes. When she got to the right side of the machete's handle, she paused at seeing some faded letters covered by some dirt.
MTC,
said Izzy, narrowing her eyes.
Is that a name on the handle?
How did you find that?
The first unicorn came over and looked at the faded letters on the right side of the machete, and his eyes widened.
Whoa. We might be able to find out who this traveler was!
Izzy giggled excitedly. First, she got her friends and found an artifact all in 1 week.
Wait, shouldn't you have noticed that earlier?
Izzy asked, suddenly confused.
We just got here,
said the first unicorn.
We had to evaluate the Earth Pony's find.
Izzy blinked.
Oh.
A few minutes later, Izzy knew of the owner of the machete's name and was trotting happily to Sunny's house.
I can't believe I found that!
She then giggled.
I might be a part-time pony to find things of the past!
She paused, tapping her chin.
What's that called again?
She shrugged.
Eh, never mind.
Izzy began trotting onwards to Sunny's house and saw the lighthouse tower that was completely restored due to having magical neighbors and it was restored to its former glory.
It's a shame that the red pony got Pearl for a month after a crystal adventure.
Izzy thought, as she reached Sunny's door.
But maybe we'll be friends soon. Sunny!
Izzy sang, swinging the door open. She heard it impact the wall and she turned to the left wall, seeing the restored picture of Philly Sunny and her father Crooked.
Oops.
She put a hoof and straightened it up. The unicorn turned back in the direction of the living room and kitchen.
Sunny!
No response except her echo. Izzy lifted her ears, searched the floor and the second floor that wasn't completely restored.
Huh.
Izzy furrowed her brows.
This isn't like Sunny.
She tapped her chin and left the house, shutting the door, only to pop back in and straighten the picture once again. Izzy trotted all around Sunny's yard and next to the nearby forest, but there was no sign of her best friend. However, when she came upon a smaller road that she hadn't noticed before, the unicorn looked to see that there was a small opening within the forest. Curious and hoping to find Sunny, she trotted down that path for a little while. Then, at the edge of it, she saw the back of Sunny. Her eyes lit up and she was about to call out to her, but she noticed that the Earth Pony looked to be sad and looking at a stone in front of her, with her head down. Frowning with confusion and concern, Izzy slowed down her trot and made her way over to a nearby tree to see what was going on. As the sun's light streams past the trees, their branches, and very lush green leaves, there was a small stream running through the small clearing. But she couldn't hear what Sunny was saying, if anything at all. So she snuck to the closest tree to look over at her.
And that's what happened in the past year.
Sunny's voice came through, much to Izzy's relief.
I've accomplished so much after so many unsuccessful attempts.
Sunny continued.
And if only you are here to hug and congratulate me for all I've done.
She paused, and Izzy's ears flattened.
You'd love to meet the Pegasi unicorn I made friends with. They're wonderful. I just...
A light sob emitted from Sunny.
I just wish that some days were easier with you not here with me. Dad, I love you so much.
Sunny placed her head on the gravestone.
Her father's gone?
Izzy felt a sharp pain of sadness pierce her heart. She thought he must have been elsewhere and she didn't think about it. And Sunny? Oh, Izzy wanted to rush over and hug her. But before she could do so...
I wish they could see all three tribes have reunited once again.
Sunny said, placing a tender hoof on the gravestone.
I did my part, Dad. Hoof to heart.
Izzy was about to run over, but then she stepped on a twig, making a loud snapping sound that caused her to freeze, and Sunny's head to perk up and look around.
Who's out there?
Sunny asked, alarmed.
It's me!
Izzy came out from behind a tree and held up a hoof when Sunny saw her, and she visibly calmed down some.
Izzy? What are you doing out here?
Sunny asked.
I was looking for you,
said Izzy, walking over to the Earth Pony.
We had our day today with the others, and I couldn't find you.
Oh.
Sunny paused, glancing once back at the grave.
I forgot.
Izzy looked over at the grave, and saw it was engraved Argyle Starshine, with some symbols that looked like a star, a bolt, three butterflies, diamonds, apples, and balloons.
Who's Argyle?
Izzy asked softly, and Sunny sighed.
I can't keep it in anymore.
Huh?
I'm sorry.
Sunny said, looking back at the grave.
I wanted to tell you, but I was just so focused on our friendship and...
She turned fully back to the gravestone and sat back down. Izzy sat next to her and gently placed a forelegger on the Earth Pony.
It's okay,
Izzy whispered. Sunny sniffled and wiped her eyes.
I need to tell you,
Sunny admitted.
I can't keep something like this from my best friend.
Izzy felt her heart warm up, and she just sat there.
My dad was the most special pony in my life,
Sunny began.
He taught me everything I knew about Earth ponies, unicorns, and Pegasi living in harmony so long ago.
She faintly smiled.
We played, laughed, and enjoyed one another's company so much. He made me little toys too.
She frowned again, and Izzy stroked Sunny's withers.
I never knew my mom, because she died during childbirth. And my dad?
She looked at Izzy, tears filling her eyes.
Sickness took him. Oh, Sunny.
Izzy lamented, her heart heavy.
I allow myself to be here at my father's grave every year, on the day that he died.
Sunny explained.
I'm always doing my best to stay positive and cheerful.
She sighed.
But sometimes, with how close we were, it's not always easy. Oh.
Izzy said sadly.
I didn't realize. I was a misfit in our town,
Sunny continued.
And aside from Hitch, my dad was the closest pony I ever had. And so lose him.
She choked, tears rolling down the Earth Pony's cheeks. It was then that Izzy enveloped Sunny in a huge bear hug. The Earth Pony immediately returned it and cried on the unicorn's shoulder. A couple of tears built up behind Izzy's eyes as she held her best friend close.
I'm so sorry, Sunny,
Izzy whispered, wishing that she could say more.
It's alright.
Sunny pulled back, wiping her tears.
I keep doing my part, by being cheerful and optimistic for his sake. It was his final wish before.
Izzy nodded.
I understand. I needed this,
Sunny said, getting up.
I hope it'll bring me more closure.
Izzy just looked at her and didn't move, processing all that she had just found out.
So, let's go and have a fun day with our friends,
Sunny said happily, her former sadness seemingly forgotten.
Right.
Izzy forced a smile and got to her hooves.
That's why I came.
Sunny began jumping ahead, and Izzy followed behind. And so for the entire day, Sunny, Izzy, Hitch, Zip, and Pip all hung out together doing all kinds of wonderful and fun activities. Despite her best efforts throughout the day, Izzy wasn't as happy or into the things that she and her friends were doing, but she hoped that they didn't notice. That evening, while the sun was setting, Izzy was sitting on a small hilltop looking at the sky washed with gold, red, and purple. She had to get away from her friends. The events with Sunny at her father's grave just shook her perspective of the Happy Earth Pony, and she couldn't believe how sad it was.
Izzy, what's wrong?
A voice asked, and Izzy snapped her head to look at Zip, who descended from the sky.
Nothing.
Izzy fibbed, hoping Zip would take the bait, but Zip just raised a concerned eyebrow with a frown.
I noticed that you weren't as positive during our time together,
said Zip, walking over and stopping next to the unicorn whose ears flattened on her head.
Can you keep a little secret for now?
Izzy asked as Zip took a seat.
Sure.
When I visited Sunny this morning,
Izzy lowered her head.
I found her in an unexpected place.
Where?
Zip tilted her head.
In front of her father's grave.
Zip's eyes widened and then she frowned.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I am too,
replied Izzy, feeling very bad for Sunny.
He was taken from her by a sickness, and Sunny works so hard to maintain her spirits and spreading friendship. It's how she honors his memory. That sounds sweet.
Zip gave a soft smile, but then she frowned.
Has this been bothering you the whole day?
Yes,
Izzy admitted, sitting back up.
It was just so unexpected. I just don't know how to deal with it.
Both ponies just looked at each other for a minute, as Izzy looked back at the setting sun.
My father died when I was a filly.
Zip admitted, and Izzy gasped, looking at the Pegasus with eyes as wide as dinner plates.
He was killed in an accident.
I'm so sorry, Zip.
Izzy frowned, feeling sorry for her and Pip.
It's all right,
said Zip, giving her a reassuring smile.
But the incident brought Pip and I close together.
Her smile dwindled some.
My mom and I were a little bit different because of her duties and...
She lightly grimaced.
Faking our flights.
How did you deal with him being gone like that?
Izzy asked, placing a gentle hoof on the Pegasus' shoulder.
I had my friends from an early age. Family too.
Zip explained, smiling a bit.
And we grew and healed from them.
Sunny didn't have... mostly any of that.
Izzy sighed.
I see.
Replied Zip.
And I've seen how much it's impacted you.
Izzy looked away, but she immediately was guided by a hoof to look back at Zip.
But she has us now, and we'll be there for her like you were.
Mm-hmm.
Izzy hummed with uncertainty. Both ponies looked back out at the sun, which was mostly gone now and it would be time to leave soon. But then...
I just got a great idea!
Izzy cheered right back up, springing onto her hooves and knocking a surprised Zip onto her back.
Zip, there was something Sunny said to me about her father!
What's that?
Zip picked herself up, rubbing the side of her head.
She told me that he taught her everything that she knew!
Izzy explained, holding a hoof up.
She knew everything that he knew, and if he hadn't done that, then Sunny wouldn't have gotten to do what she did for all of us!
Zip's eyes widened as she gained a look of realization.
So, I just got the greatest idea!
Izzy said happily.
What is it?
Zip asked with genuine intrigue.
What if we honor Sunny's father for all he taught Sunny and helped bring Equestria's magic back?
Whoa, now that's a wonderful idea.
Zip said with a smile.
Anything to help Sunny and to let her friendship is what'll help us get through everything.
Izzy began hopping away.
Come on, I can make us all bouquets!
Wait up!
Izzy, I appreciate you walking with me, but where are we going?
Sunny asked as she and Izzy walked down a dirt path past Sunny's damaged home that was currently being restored by other ponies.
I just wanted to do something special for you.
Izzy smiled.
But we already do have something special. What else could there be?
Sunny asked, furrowing her brows.
I need to do something for you.
Izzy gave a solemn, sympathetic smile.
And your father.
Sunny lightly gasped, but Izzy gently pulled her along as questions arose in her mind. Izzy took her down the path leading to her father's gravesite, and Izzy gave a look to her that said,
Trust me.
Sunny listened as she and her friend arrived back at the grave, the beautiful night sky and moon on display in the break of the trees.
What are we doing here?
Sunny finally asked.
I want to honor your father's memory.
Replied Izzy, pulling out a bouquet of blue and violet flowers. Sunny gasped and her eyes slowly grew very wide.
We all do.
Izzy pointed behind the earth pony and Sunny turned around. Her eyes got a little wider when she saw Hitch, Zip, and Pip giving her smiles that were happy but a little bit solemn.
You... What?
Sunny squeaked.
I... Don't say too much.
Zip said as she was the first to step forward.
This is for you and your dad.
Sunny's mouth sealed shut as the Pegasus walked past her and in front of her father's grave, stopping just in front of it. Sunny stood close by and just watched, her emotions swirling.
My name is Zip, and I'm one of Sunny's new friends.
Zip began.
I might have not known you, Mr. Argyle, but I would have loved to meet you for all the tales that you had of ancient Equestria. You raised a fantastic daughter that's kind, smart, and very bright.
Sunny began to smile, very touched at her words.
I'm sure that you were the best father that she could have asked for.
She knelt and placed the bouquet of white, blue, and purple flowers on the stone.
Thank you, Argyle.
The Pegasus walked up to Sunny and gave her a surprising hug, and she returned it. Zip pulled back and Pip was next, holding a bouquet of pink flowers.
You are no doubt a fabulous and noble father to your daughter, Mr. Argyle.
Pip said.
I appreciate you and what you taught her so much so all of us and every pony else could be together once again.
She placed her bouquet down.
And I truly hope it lasts.
The Pip-Pop Pegasus hugged Sunny, and she returned it before pulling away and Hitch stepped up.
I know I already paid my respects.
Hitch began.
But after everything, I've gained a lot more appreciation for you, Argyle.
He gave a brief soft smile to Sunny.
We all thought that you were crazy, but it turns out we were the ones that were crazy. All of us will work together to create a better future. Thank you, Argyle.
He placed his bouquet on his grave and he hugged Sunny, the Earth Pony's tears falling before he pulled away. There was only Izzy left, and she was standing there with a smile, but with caring eyes.
I have so much to thank you for, Mr. Argyle.
Izzy said, and Sunny couldn't stop the tears from flowing. She lightly gasped when the unicorn pulled out a very familiar drawing that Sunny and her father did to invite other ponies into Maritime Bay.
If you two hadn't made this drawing,
Izzy continued, as Sunny's heart melted.
I wouldn't have come to Maritime Bay or had met Sunny, the greatest pony and friend I've ever had. You're just the best pony I've never met, and I hope to carry on your flame with Sunny until the end.
She placed the picture and bouquet down.
May your sparkle shine forever, Mr. Argyle.
Izzy looked up with a smile, and Sunny ran over and gave a big bear hug to the unicorn. Lightly sobbing, and she felt four legs wrap around her, as she was pulled away from the grave. She and Izzy sat on the grass as every pony gathered around her.
You guys,
said Sunny, choking and tearing up.
Thank you so much.
All of them pulled Sunny into a group hug and all embraced one another as true friends. Sunny softly sobbed in their warm four legs and wings. She opened her eyes and happened to be looking up at the starry sky in the direction of the grave and moon. She swore she saw her father smiling proudly down at her. Dude, if you want emotion, this is the way to go. Like, the author did such a beautiful job with this. There's no other way to put it but just perfection. Anyways, enough of me obsessing over this, and let's get on to our very sweet donators. Top donators: Peter Coulthard, J-Tin Man, Darkside, Gauntlet, and Only One Thing. Zar630, Strix, Raiden, Narwhals, Black Moonheart, Drake Love Dragon, Pastel Skies, Austin Roland, CrazyColor557, Stu Hex, Will, Omicron Lyrae, Dospo, Delta Omega, Jack Hadge, RuneScythe9852, MadMad Stan, Leslie Prickett, Hunter Norman, Stephen Bingham, LineGuy12, Sorcerer Constantine, Hud Zaza, and many more awesome people. Thank you all so much for watching this video, and live life to the fullest.